This week on the Rumorg Archives, we head back to May 2010 from Rumorg issue number 100. Rumorg proudly presents the ongoing story of the genre's greatest living legend and the studio that made him an icon, an interview with Christopher Lee by James Burrell. Say the words genre royalty and one name is bound to come up more than any other, Christopher Lee. With a career that has spanned 7 decades and is still going strong, the legendary actor has played everything from swashbuckling pirates to insidious villains to revered political leaders. But it's his work in the horror, science fiction, and fantasy genres that has built his most loyal fan base. Although known to the average modern moviegoer as villains Saruman in the Lord of the Rings trilogy and Count Dooku in the Star Wars prequels, Lee remains, to horror fans at least, closely identified with the roles he played for England's Hammer Studios, particularly that of Count Dracula. He donned the fangs 7 times for the company over the course of 16 years, plus once for director Jess Franco, and later he even played Vlad the Impaler for a documentary. Of aristocratic ancestry himself, Christopher Frank Carandini Lee was born on May 27, 1922, in the district of Belgravia in Westminster, England. His mother, Estelle Marie Carandini, was an Italian contessa. His father, Geoffrey Lee, was a lieutenant colonel with Britain's 60th King's Royal Rifle Corps. When he was 4, Lee's parents separated, with his mother later marrying Harcourt Rose, a banker and relation to James Bond creator Ian Fleming. Graduating from Wellington College, where he majored in classical studies, Lee went on to serve in World War II in Britain's Royal Air Force, or RAF, and as an intelligence officer with the British Army. After he retired from the RAF at the end of the war, he was encouraged by his mother's cousin Niccolo Carandini, the Italian ambassador to Britain, to try acting. Once declared the most bankable star in the world by USA Today, Lee is as busy as ever with several projects in the works, including The Resident, the first feature release from relaunched Hammer Films, and The Wicker Tree, the follow-up to The Wicker Man. Sir Christopher Lee granted Rumorg an extensive interview from his home in England, in which his commanding voice described a career of unparalleled distinction. Let's talk about your return to Hammer. You recently completed The Resident with Hilary Swank, your first film for the Reborn Studio in approximately 35 years. How does it feel to be back on a Hammer film? Well, it's something that I never expected would happen. I congratulate the people who are running Hammer now for having the name restarted and for making motion pictures again. It's a strange feeling in a way, it's like coming full circle. And what I did with Hilary Swank wasn't a very great deal, but I think she's a very fine actress, and I think that co-star Jeffrey Dean Morgan is a very fine actor. So it was a pleasant surprise, really. I had to travel a long way to do it, to Albuquerque, New Mexico. I think it will be a very good film, slightly along the lines of, but not in terms of Devilish Possession or anything like that, Rosemary's Baby. I'm not saying it's the same, because it isn't, but it's a very strange, unsettling film, which was very demanding for the leading players. My part was a short part, but a very meaningful one. Would you say that the horror genre still interests you today as an actor? If it's done by suggestion, only if it's done by keeping the audience in suspense. If you had to do it all over again, would you have been more firm in your refusal to play Dracula those last few times? Yes, I think I would have. Play it once for Hammer and once for Jess Franco with a proper budget so we could really have told Stoker's story. I do say Stoker's lines in that version, not enough, but many of them. Nobody's done it, you know. Nobody has done the story exactly as Stoker wrote it. Is there an element about heavy metal music that appeals to you in particular? Yes, power. Gunpowder, if you like. An element which an actor must have, and in this particular instance, the singers. This type of music is very powerful. It's certainly another step in my career. Another string in my bow, you might say. How was your interest in the occult born? Can you attribute it to any event in your life? It's probably because when I was young, I was a classical scholar in Latin and Greek, and of course that meant knowing the mythology. And I became particularly interested in Nordic mythology. In The Wicker Man, there's a lot of Celtic myth, pagan belief, and sacrifice. I've been interested in mythology all my life. I still read books about it from countries all over the world. What do you think is your greatest role? I went to Pakistan in 1997 for 10 weeks to play the founder of the nation, Muhammad Ali Jinnah. And that's the title of the film, Jinnah. That's the biggest challenge I've ever had, playing the role in front of his own people, who greeted me with enormous kindness and praise. I think that's probably the best thing I've ever done. At this point in your life, what do you fear the most? Well, everybody fears something, don't they? I think above all, I'm a bit afraid of the unknown. And speaking on an entirely personal basis, I don't want to die before any other members of my family. You understand what I mean by that? I have a fear, obviously. I don't know how to define it, really. We're all gonna die, but I'm not ready yet. I remember two wonderful comments. Vincent Price said that if he had a gravestone, it would say, "I'll be back." And Jack Lemmon, who does have a gravestone, had it inscribed with Jack Lemmon in. And if I had a gravestone or a memoriam of any kind, I think it would probably say, "Too soon." For the full interview with Christopher Lee and more, be sure to pick up Rue Morgue number 100, the May 2010 issue, now available in the Rue Morgue shop. Link below. Join us next time for another classic column from the pages of Rue Morgue magazine.